Suzanne Smiley here at RFD Journal Live 2014. We are at Extreme's booth with Tim Hoffman. Tim, how are you doing today?
It's great to be here, and thanks for coming to our booth. We're always happy to have you. We enjoy the relationship we have with you guys and enjoy these opportunities here.
Definitely. We love having y'all's tags on our website. We just put a few on maybe a couple months ago.
Right.
So we wanted to do a whole booth look at what y'all have, what opportunities y'all have for the customers and everything. So take us through what you brought to RFD Journal Live.
Just talk a little bit about our tag portfolio that we have here. These are our current tags. We've got a variety of tags, our metal mount tags at the top. This is one that we just introduced, and I don't think it's on your website yet, but it will be.
Oh, it will be.
And then this is one we've just done some preliminary testing, a high temperature tag.
Oh, okay.
That we expected to have a range of around 500 degrees Fahrenheit for temperature. So that'll be great for automotive applications, paint applications, things like that. We've got some great small container tags. These go into things like fish containers, produce containers, things like that. These are our metal mount tags that are used for trucks and large containers. This one is kind of neat. It's flexible, so you can flex this tag. And then this is, and then these are for medium-sized containers. This is a 20-foot read range for plastic containers. We're showing both the ability to the human readable through the tag. This label is embedded within the tag.
So it can't come off.
Exactly. You can spray that, you can sandblast it, and the label doesn't come off.
Right.
And then our Duo tag, which of course you guys have on your website, gives you two identical tags for attaching to when you put multiple tags on containers.
Right.
And then of course there's our Flex tag, another one of your tags that you're showing. So it's a completely flexible tag, very durable, great hang tag.
Wow, yeah, and it's good for containers that have a round shape to them.
Right.
It can go any way you want it to,
and it's a soft hang tag if you want to put it on safety equipment or things like that.
Okay, all right, awesome.
So this is our current portfolio.
Really cool. We all got some really cool tags, and we love having them on our site, so... What is this down here a different one, or
this is
our, the same
one? It's the same as these other, but that's just a black version of this tag. So this, you can see the human readable through it. This is the snap-in, but it's the same tag.
You've got to have color options, right?
Exactly, we do have color options. You'll see on this other wall over here, we have multiple color options. So
Actually,
we do have a lot of different colors available, as well as types of materials, whether it's flexible or rigid. So in our booth, we're just showing some of the applications in which our tags have been put into agricultural containers, where they're bringing the produce from the field to the manufacturing facilities. Of course, automotive manufacturing, oil and gas. Again, our tags are high durability. They're single-piece tags. So especially in things like oil and gas, where you're concerned about chemicals, because our tags with their one-piece, single-piece construction, they will withstand harsh chemicals such as acetone without without any ingress of that chemical into the tag. That is something that's unique about the Extreme tags versus a lot of other rigid tags on the markets.
To learn some more about the design ideas that Extreme has for the different tags. So go ahead and take us through this, Mike, and see what y'all have going on.
Okay, so as this wall explains, here's six areas that we can customize tags. So our niche in the space is that we can customize tags to meet the exact requirements of the customers. So how they're attached to an asset, the type of material that we encapsulate, the RFID inlay inside, the environmental constraints, chemical resistance, temperatures, the footprint, which is the shape or size, what RF performance, so we can customize the RF performance to meet the application, and then visual identification. So if you look over here, just to give you some ideas, so we can customize, put customers' logos or information on the outside of the tag. This just gives different examples. We can make rigid tags or flexibility. We have different flexibility and hardness we can make, and we have a company that can compound resins to meet exact requirements. We can do all these beautiful colors. And this tag is interesting. It was actually designed for commercial fishing nets and had unique requirements. It had to be flexible to flex with the fishing net, had to withstand salt water, but then it also had to withstand sun because the nets would be out on a dock for a long period of time. So we had to customize a resin for that. can do a whole palette of colors, pretty much any colors you want.
Love the pink.
We can do different attachment methods. So this is a two-wheel trash can that's rolled out to the curb. This is the upper rim of that trash can. And what we used is a metal clip to attach the RFID tag up in the rim. So no tools. It's Mike Lewis proof. I can snap it up so anybody can do it, make it simple. This is also good for prototyping and doing proof of concept. This, we call this our plaque. It's just a three inch by 6 inch sheet of material, but we can make different resins, different shapes, and then with that, we can make die cuts out of it to customize tags for people to do proof of concept. But then we can also do 3D prototyping. So this uses a 3D printer, and we can encapsulate it around an actual RFID inlay, so it's a working prototype that people can touch, feel, test, and do proof of concept.
So is that for poker uses only?
This was for poker uses, so I never run out of money. It's
exactly.
Great.
Exactly.
And this one was unique. The customer needed it to go on a gas cylinder, so it fits down on the neck of a gas cylinder, but it had to keep the RFID tag up off the metal, so we were able to customize that design.
Wow, okay,
so
really cool.
So a lot of, really, limitations, creativity and imagination.
We're here at RFD Journal Lab, still at the Extreme booth with Lindsay this time. How are you doing today?
Great, it's been a good show so far.
Hasn't it? It's so big this year, so we're loving that. She's gonna take us through the process y'all do for customization to get the customers what they need, exactly how they need it. So go through what that process is and how you get there.
Sure. So Extreme RFID manufactures rugged RFID tags. We take various inlays from the industry and fully encapsulate them through a plastic injection molding process. So we do have current tags, and sometimes customer is looking for a specific application that one of our existing tags just doesn't quite fit for. And so we have a process called Ideate, which stands for Idea, Design, Engineer, Adjust, Test, and Execute. And what we do is go through six customization categories with our customers to really drill down to what they need for their application. The categories are attachment, encapsulation material, environment that the tag might have to withstand, so in outdoor environments, things like that, different chemicals. Then we go to the footprint of the tag, the size, shape, form factor, and then the visual identification and RF performance of the tag. So what type of inlay are they looking for, HF, LF, and UHF. And once we drill down through those categories with them, we can really understand, do they need a flexible tag? Do they need a color-coded tag? Do they need a tag with human-readable numbers, clear resin, branding, those types of things. And so at that point, we're able to really customize a tag for them. During our test process, we can do a 3D prototyping for the customer to give them a tag to actually test on their application, on their asset. And if that works, we can adjust as needed from there and then actually manufacture the exact tag that they're looking for their application, which is our execute portion of the Ideate process.
Well, great. So you can get exactly what they want to withstand whatever chemical or whatever size, shape, color, anything that they need specific for their application.
Right, and all of our tags have an IP68 rating because we do a total encapsulation through plastic injection molding. So there aren't two pieces coming together, it's one fully encapsulated inlay. And so that's why we really want to get down to what that customer needs for their application, whether it be it needs to resist impact or abrasion, whether it's going through high pressure washing with chemicals, that type of thing. We want to make sure we know exactly what their tag needs to withstand before we go through the full process,
right,
and we can test and adjust as necessary throughout until we get to the executable project.
Okay, well, fabulous. Any other advice on this system? Anything you want to tell us before we head out of the booth for today?
Sure. I mean, the Ideate process really works for any type of customer. So whether we're working with system integrators that have various customers in various fields, we can work with them to come up with tags that work for all of those applications. Or if it's a manufacturer looking to manufacture a tag into their actual, if it's an OEM, that's a really great part of the process to get started with us at, because we can manufacture the tag to work right into the manufacturing process of the part. So we have tag examples that where we've built them, they can be manufactured into another plastic part and then taken on from there. So you never have to worry about an attachment method that might come loose or be jostled in a process. It goes through handling of the project and of the asset. And so it's really, we work with a gambit of customers, and the Ideate process works anywhere in the range of RFID customers that are out there.
Well, great. Well, we love working with Extreme. We love having those products on our website. Hopefully, we'll get some more soon up there. So we're about to leave. It was great talking to you, Lindsay, and I hope you have a great rest of the day.
Thank you.